I'm here to talk of some of the key expectations of the IT service sector from the forthcoming budget 2020. I would talk of three key expectations. One is the extension of the sunset clause for the SEZ income tax holiday under Section 10AA of the Income Tax Act. While the government has reduced the corporate taxes, there is an expectation that the government will extend this and give the tax holiday for a couple of more years. The reason being that recently the government amended the SEZ rules to allow the SEZs to now act as multi-sector SEZs, which means that more and more companies can come and set up their operations in SEZs. This gives scope to the IT companies as well to move into larger SEZs, and therefore if they have to make more investment, which also means better employment generation, there has to be certain tax incentives given. So that is an expectation coming out of the IT service companies. The second expectation is that the government supports the digital segment, which today is a prominent segment for the IT services companies. To give you some statistics, today about 20% of IT service companies' revenues comes from the digital segment. Out of the overall $150 billion, 20% is digital. When I say digital, it is social media, mobility, analytics, and cloud computing. It's a segment which most of the companies are focusing on. It requires a lot of reskilling of employees, a lot of R&D in terms of the operations. And reskilling and R&D means a lot of investment. Therefore, the companies expect that the government gives some tax credits to support them. Lastly, it's a little administrative expectation that the government solves companies' litigation problems. It is true with any sector. A lot of money is stuck in litigation. Companies are looking forward for some sort of amnesty or settlement schemes.